Let us pray. Holy God, your blessings are abundant and your wisdom exceeds our understanding. Fill us with your Spirit as we hear your word this day, that we may be justice seekers and peacemakers, sharing your life among those who are forgotten, weak, or persecuted, and revealing to all your glory. Amen.
Good morning. Our Old Testament reading this morning comes from Micah chapter 6, verses 1 through 8, which can be found in the Pew Bible on page 951. The Lord's case against Israel. Listen to what the Lord says. Stand up, plead my case before the mountains. Let the hills hear what you have to say. Hear, you mountains, the Lord's accusation. Listen, you everlasting foundations of the earth, for the Lord has a case against his people. He is lodging a charge against Israel. My people, what have I done to you? How have I burdened you? Answer me. I brought you up out of Egypt and redeemed you from the land of slavery. I sent Moses to lead you, also Aaron and Miriam. My people, remember what Balak, king of Moab, plotted and what Balaam, son of Beor, answered. Remember your journey from Shittim to Gilgal, that you may know the righteous acts of the Lord. With what shall I come before the Lord and bow down before the exalted God? Shall I come before him with burnt offerings, with calves a year old? Will the Lord be pleased with thousands of rams, with 10,000 rivers of olive oil? Shall I offer my firstborn for my transgressions, the fruit of my body for the sin of my soul? He has shown you, O mortal, what is good, and what does the Lord require of you? To act justly, to love mercy, to walk humbly with our God. Our Old Testament reading comes from the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 5, verses 1 through 12, which can be found on page 984. Introduction to the Sermon on the Mount. Now when Jesus saw the crowds, he went up on a mountainside and sat down. His disciples came to him, and he began to teach them. He said, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the earth. Blessed are the merciful, for they will be shown mercy. And blessed are the pure in heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called the children of God. Blessed are those who are persecuted because of righteousness, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when people insult you, persecute you, and falsely say all kinds of evil against you because of me. Rejoice and be glad, because great is your reward in heaven, for in the same way they persecuted the prophets who were before you." The word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God.
Let us pray. Almighty God, may the words of my mouth and the meditations of all of our hearts be acceptable in your sight. O Lord, our rock and our redeemer. Amen. Apparently, I'm not the only one who is feeling this particular way, because there have been some very interesting and funny little quips going around social media the last few days, and one summed up my feelings quite well. It said, 2020 has been a long year. I'm ready for it to be over. Anybody else feeling that way? We've only made it to February. I pray to God we have nowhere to go but up. But I don't get a say in that. Life is often, it seems too often, not what we would expect or hope. Life is difficult. The amazing thing is that Jesus promised us not happiness, not an easy life, but Jesus promised us life abundant. But he didn't say it would be tiptoeing through the tulips. And yet people followed him anyway, because they saw in him the very presence of God in the midst of life's messiness. He doesn't just wave a hand and make it all go away. He is with us in the middle of it and does not abandon or forsake us. Now, I don't know about you, but if there's anybody that I want with me in the middle of the messiness of life, it is the very Son of God. For what would we have to fear? What could destroy us? Not even death. Not even that greatest of all enemies, the one that none of us can hide from, not even death will win. You see, the reason people followed Jesus was that in him they saw the very kingdom of God made flesh. They saw what all things were supposed to be in him. When people expected judgment, such as the adulterous woman, Jesus responded, "Let you who is without sin cast the first stone." He takes the expectations of this world and turns them upside down. He takes what's wrong in this world and makes it right. And we are called to be like him, to continue the work that he does, to show the world around us what it looks like to live and be in the kingdom of heaven now, not just after we die, Micah chapter 6, verse 8 is one of my favorite verses. In fact, if I could pull out just one verse about what is most important, this is one of them, at least one of my top three. What does the Lord require of you? What does God want from you? It's not for you to poke out your eye when you sin. It's not for you to give your firstborn child to make everything right. What does God want from you? But to do justice, to love kindness, and to walk humbly with God. Friends, that is what kingdom living looks like. We need to unpack this just a little bit because words are not always as they seem. If you don't believe me, listen to a politician. So let me unpack this a little bit. To do justice. Too often, the word justice tends to apply to the bad guys getting what they deserve. There's more to it. There's so much more to it. You see, justice for those who commit wrong is punishment. But that's not the only kind of justice. Justice is also those who are weak are made strong. Those who are broken are made whole. The wrongs in this world are made right. The people who cannot care for themselves are cared for by someone else. That is also justice. Taking the wrongs of this world and making them right. Now, I've only walked on this earth 42 years now. Maybe a lot of my naivety was due to childhood, but at least my experience in life is it seems to be that there are more things wrong today than there were 5 years ago, or 10 years ago, or 20 years ago. Am I exaggerating? It seems like every time I wake up, the world around me gets worse. And just when I think it can't get worse, it happens again. Friends, this world needs people who are working for justice. Not the eye for an eye and tooth for a tooth kind of justice, but the kind of justice where the people who cannot do for themselves have someone help them. I believe it was Desmond Tutu who said, we need to stop pulling people out of the river and we need to go upriver and find out why they are falling in. This world needs us. It needs us to be people who love and do justice. And certainly people who love kindness. I never thought in my lifetime that there would be signs in people's yards reminding themselves and their neighbors to choose kindness. Has anybody seen those signs? Yeah. What does that say about us? That we need to remind each other through lawn signs to choose kindness. And yet we look at the places of power and authority in our country and we see nothing even close to resembling basic human kindness. This is where we step in. We have to be those people. We have to be the ones who choose to be kind to our neighbor, regardless of who they voted for. No matter how wrong we are sure that they are, we must choose kindness. For me, these are building up. Doing justice is so important. Choosing kindness is even more important. But the biggest is walking humbly with God. How do we do that? I see it happen every day. I see it happening in you. I saw it just the other day in the ladies gathered again in the kitchen to serve a family of our own who's grieving. That is walking humbly with God. I see it in the hugs and the prayers and the love and the support of this community for each other. That is walking humbly with God. I see it in the ways that we reach out beyond ourselves to our neighbors who are in need. That also is walking humbly with God. You see, one of the challenges of all three of these things is that we have no control over anyone else's journey. We can't make them do justice and love kindness and walk humbly with God. But we can choose that ourselves. So let this be our challenge to follow in the way of Jesus, to show this world who is really blessed. It's not the powerful, it's not the rich, it is those who are meek and lowly, those who mourn, and those who are peacemakers. They are blessed because someone is out there doing justice, loving kindness, and walking humbly with God. Let's be that someone. Amen. Please stand as you are able for our affirmation of faith as is printed in the bulletin. This is the good news that we have received, in which we stand and by which we are saved, if we hold it fast, that Christ died for our sins according to the Scriptures, that he was buried, that he was raised on the third day, and that he appeared first to the women, then to Peter and to the 12, and then to many faithful witnesses. We believe that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of the living God. Jesus Christ is the first and the last, the beginning and the end. He is our Lord and our God. Amen. Friends, go forth doing justice, loving kindness, and walking humbly with God. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of God's Holy Spirit abide with all of us today, tomorrow, and forevermore. And all God's people said, Amen. Amen.